Buenas tardes a todo el mundo, muchas gracias por venir. Durante unos días vamos a estar rodando con RAS y haciendo diferentes actividades, clinics, y bueno, creo que es alguien que no necesita presentación, de repercusión internacional y bueno, yo intentaré ir haciendo las traducciones, utilizaré un poco a Íñigo por todo el tema, todo el vocabulario específico de la batería y poco más. Espero que lo disfrutéis y adelante.
¡Y alegría!
Okay, hello, hello, hola. You gonna help translate?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Okay. Okay. So, thank you for having me here in Madrid. It's been a while since I've been here.
Gracias por recibirme aquí en Madrid.
And thanks to the store and Agustín and everyone who's having me. Yeah, thanks for having us. And of course, Ruben from Mapex drums. Also Zildjian cymbals, Vic Firth and Remo, who helped with these songs.
Remo y
yeah. So, I'm here to do a few things. Obviously, play a little bit, and also for us to meet each other.
He venido para deciros algunas cosas, para tocar y también para poder conocernos entre nosotros.
Yeah. So it's really important to me that we meet each other and you can ask questions and we can talk and everybody here learns something tonight, not only just you but me as well.
Entonces para mí es importante que participéis, que compartáis y que podamos entre todos interactuar y aprender vosotros y también, por supuesto, aprender.
So what I'm going to do is play a little bit and hopefully, you know, we can talk a lot about playing techniques or ideas. And then also tonight, we're also going to discuss a little bit about how a drum is actually constructed and how it's made and some ideas about why a drum sounds the way it does.
Entonces hablaremos sobre las técnicas de tocar y también un poco sobre la construcción de la batería y cómo influye en lo que tocamos.
Yeah, and hopefully what that'll do is give you an idea of how to choose an instrument, like whatever instrument is best for you, and it'll give you an idea of what to look for and how to choose it correctly. So.
Entonces lo que intentaré, entre otras cosas, es ayudaros a encontrar la batería o el sonido que os puede venir bien o necesitáis.
Okay, so first thing I might do is play a couple songs just to give you an idea of what I do. If you don't know that much about me, I mean, I've done many different acts, a lot of different acts and records with a lot of different styles over the years.
Entonces lo primero que voy a hacer es tocar un par de temas. Si no sabéis, para quienes no me conozcáis, yo soy alguien que está acostumbrado a tocar mucho y muchos estilos, variando mucho.
So everything from, you know, Slash, from Guns N' Roses to Andrea Bocelli to Psychedelic Furs to Tina Turner, Ray Charles, Christina Aguilera, Nelly Furtado, so it's all over the place. So I don't, you know, I'm not one of the drummers that, you know, got into a band, like one band, like Big Rush or something, and, you know, that was my career. It's a lot of different things with a lot of different people.
Como habéis oído, los grupos creo que los conocéis de sobra, eres alguien que no toca con una banda, toca con muchos grupos y está un poco por todo eso.
And the other thing that I do a lot is a lot of recordings. I play on the TV show American Idol in the United States, and with that TV show, we play a lot of different with a lot of different artists and a lot of different styles. But the other thing that I do a lot is a lot of recording, and that means television and movie. So a lot of movie soundtracks.
También, como habéis oído, toca en el programa de American Idol y en muchos y variados, también hace grabaciones para películas, cosa que también le obliga mucho a cambiar estilos y formas.
And one of the things about the movie soundtracks is that can be anything. It can be a rock song, or it could be, you know, I've done Avatar and Terminator Genesis and Superman and the new Superman versus Batman and many different movies, Chicken Little. So a lot of different movies. So it's a lot of different styles and things in that. So you have to be well-rounded in that as well. So I'm going to talk a lot about being well-rounded on the drums.
Pues un poco lo de antes, que una de las virtudes de la batería es que permite tocar muchos estilos y como habéis oído, pues se lo está grabando películas como Avatar, Superman, Superman vs Batman, algo de un pollo y Little Chicken. Y bueno, que lo que va a hacer es explicar un poco eso, cómo estar cómodo.
Okay, here we go. Can you guys hear the drums okay?
Yeah.
Here we go. Okay, thank you. So, one of the things, I want to make sure that everyone leaves here with something that really, how many people are drummers?
¿Cuántos soy baterías?
Okay, almost everybody, great. How many people are guitar players?
Guitarristas.
Okay. One? Now get out of here. Okay. No, I'm joking. I want to make sure that everybody leaves here tonight with something that really, really changes what they do on this instrument.
Me gustaría que fuerais hoy con algo que os haga cambiar la forma en la que lo veis.
You know, when I first started going to drum clinics, today's my birthday, so I'm 21 years old. I wish. But I was very young. My first drum clinic, I think I was maybe 8 years old. And it was Roy Burns. I don't know if you know who Roy Burns is, but Roy Burns is one of the great big band drummers. And he actually went on to start Aquarian Drumheads. So if you know Aquarian Drumheads, Roy Burns is the owner of that.
Que es el dueño de Aquarian, de los parches Aquarian.
Okay, so when I was young, you know, drum clinics are very different than what they are now. And so the first thing I want to say is I appreciate everybody coming out tonight and being here for this.
Pues, lo primero, cuando era joven, los clinics eran muy diferentes de lo que son ahora. Entonces, lo primero que quiero hacer es agradeceros a todos que hayáis venido.
But when I was young, you know, it was an opportunity to meet a drummer that you heard on a record or you saw at a concert or saw on TV or whatever and ask them questions. And at that time, great drummers like Roy Burns or Bernard Purdy or some of those great drummers, they always taught a lot at a clinic, so you learned a lot at a drum clinic. It wasn't about just watching them play for an hour and a half.
En aquel tiempo los clinics eran momentos donde los clinistas hablaban mucho, mucho más de lo que tocaban, y entonces aportaban mucho y se aprendía mucho.
So I think drum clinics in recent years, you know, guys made it more of a performance. And, you know, I want to play a bunch for you guys, but I also want to make sure that there's some questions and we talk about things, and I have some stuff I want you to leave here with, so I'm going to start talking about that.
Entonces, lo que él quiere hacer es, porque cree que los clinics ahora son más para, o sea, hay mucha gente que busca más tocar que hablar y contar y transmitir, a él le gustaría poder hablar con vosotros y que os vayáis con de aquí con una nueva, con algo aprendido, ¿no?
Okay, so before I start talking about what I want to talk about, is there a question or two I could answer about anything that you saw that I just played? Because I'll forget what I did very soon.
Que si alguno de vosotros, antes de que le empiece a hablar, tiene alguna pregunta sobre lo que él ha tocado, o cómo lo ha tocado, o alguna cosa sobre lo que ha hecho.
Yes, no.
Yes. Okay. Free copy of my album to the first question.
Un CD gratis para la primera pregunta.
Still no. There you go. See? Here. It's got Steve Gadd and Steve Smith and me and a bunch of other guys on it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
How do you gain control on the bass?
Castellano.
Ah, ¿cómo ganas control en el bombo? Ha tocado el bombo muchas dinámicas distintas. Si lo haces con el talón en alto, ¿cuál es el, o sea, algún ejercicio o algo así? ¿Qué recomiendas para desarrollar ese control de dinámica del bombo?
So you can you can say it in English, right? You can say you can say it in English.
My English is not very well.
Oh, it's better than my Spanish.
How do you play the bass drum with so many dynamics?
Okay.
Do you play with heel up?
Yeah, okay, alright, I'll tell you. Okay, so the question is about foot technique, pedal technique. So bombo is, you know, very, very important that you play the bass drum with the same approach that you do the hands.
Sí, sí, que la idea es tocar en, con los pies con la misma intensidad o forma que, la, que las manos.
So when we make a stroke with the hand, okay, this is the thing. I see a lot of people play the drums like this.
Él ve que mucha gente toca la batería así.
What's happening there is I'm making one note with each stroke.
Lo que ocurre es que hace una nota con cada golpe.
That's good.
Yeah.
Bueno. So this is a problem because, you know, our bodies can only go so fast, right? We can only go so fast.
Ah, que no podemos ir tan rápido.
So you might look like this. If you see someone play the drums that looks like that when, you know, they're trying to play very fast because the body can only go so fast, and what's happening is you're only, every time you're going to the instrument, you're only making one note.
Cada vez que golpeas haces una nota.
Maybe you should do it.
Yeah. Más o menos, sí, no me hago olvido. Dice que, bueno, que no se puede ir tan rápido porque cada vez que estás poniendo el brazo solamente puedes dar una nota.
Yeah, so I studied with Jim Chapin, and Jim Chapin was the protege, or the main student, of a guy named Sanford Moeller. Sanford Moeller is the guy who designed the stroke that we actually play the drums with. So Jim Chapin, one of my teachers, was his student.
Estudió con Jim Chapin, que era el mejor alumno de Sanford Moeller, y bueno, pues le enseñó la técnica esta.
Right. So the Moeller technique is hitting more than one note every time you go to the drum. So you go to the drum one time and make more than one note happen. First, different than what I showed you, which was go to the down one time and only make one note. This technique is go down one time but make many notes.
La técnica Moeller se basa en dar un golpe y conseguir más golpes.
So, yeah, so the way that works, instead of this, your elbow moves first, like this. Stroke, okay, and you can see what I do is I let the stick bounce, but I don't let it bounce that way back up here. I kind of control the bounce of it, the height of it. So down like that, with the elbow first down, let it bounce and control the height.
Vale, lo que hace es en vez de levantar el codo, lo que hace es, o sea, en vez de dar un golpe, levanta el codo, deja que rebote la baqueta, controlando que no rebote la baqueta demasiado para el siguiente golpe.
So now I can do this. I can make a small tap with just my fingers.
Yo puedo hacer ahora después de ese movimiento un pequeño tap, que es un pequeño con los dedos.
So I can down. Okay. Down. Tap. Now I can make as many taps as I want. Two, three, four
taps to here.
Yeah. So one. Can do that. Okay. But on the last tap, I make a tap, but I bring my elbow up again, just like I did in the beginning.
En el último tap, levanta el codo.
So let's say I do four. So it would be tap, 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 up, down, tap, tap, last tap with my elbow up. So down, up, okay. So I'm going to the one, uno, uno. One time, but quattro, four notes, okay? Or maybe three notes. Tap up, so down one tap, and then up. So down tap, up, 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 down, up, down, up, three, two, five. Okay, doesn't matter. So what happens is, I can play much faster with much less effort.
Puedo tocar mucho más rápido con menos esfuerzo.
So, play. So, what I'm doing there, I'm answering your question. It's a long question to answer, but so what I'm doing is making a dynamic inside of what I'm playing. A dynamic is a loud note or a soft note, right? So it has a natural dynamic because the first note is louder and then the other ones are quieter, so you get this accent.
Está haciendo un gradiente de dinámicas, pues la primera es un acento natural y las otras naturalmente no están acentuadas.
Right? You can hear that. So there's a natural dynamic in it. And that's really important because when we play the drums, you know, we're talking. What's really interesting about a musical instrument is I don't speak Spanish that well. Some of you don't speak English that well, but we all speak drums.
Está hablando que la batería es un lenguaje, que uno no hablamos inglés, otro no hablamos español, pero que la batería es un lenguaje en sí que podemos entender todo.
Right, so it's communication, we're talking to each other. And the problem is, some people sound like this.
Pero el problema es que hay gente que suena así.
They always sound like they're yelling at you on the drums.
Suena que están gritando todo el rato en la batería.
Right, so they're not talking because we don't yell at everybody when we talk.
You know,
I don't say, I'm so happy to be here in Madrid, I can't wait to come back, we're going to play some drums, make sure you ask some questions. You know, I don't talk like that, but many people play like that. And we have to play with expression just like we would talk and communicate.
Bueno, ya habéis visto que...
So instead of, you know...
So that natural dynamic inside of that stroke allows me to play different expressions and communicate and talk better through the instrument.
Que esa dinámica natural le permite expresarse mucho mejor.
Okay, so what I'm doing is taking the same technique and putting it on the foot. Okay, so
hace lo mismo los pies.
Yeah. So many people yell when they play the bass drum all the time.
Todo el mundo, pues, grita cuando toca.
Right? Always the same. Right?
Rather than...
Right? So, it grooves much more harder. You know, it has a better feel and a better pocket because I'm talking through it, I'm communicating through it.
Dice que con esta historia de la dinámica en el bombo, pues el grupo mucho mejor y lo agarra todo mucho mejor que de la otra.
Right, so when I go to play...
So I do the same three strokes with the foot, down, tap, and then up. So maybe I'll do it on this pedal so you can see it.
So down, the whole leg.
But you'll notice what happens is I don't push the beater into the head.
Hace un down allí, lo que hace es no deja la maza golpeada en el parche.
Okay, listen to the bass drum. Beater in, beater out.
El primero con la maza pegada, el segundo con la maza sin pegar.
Especially on a small drum like this. Or beater's coming out.
So una mayor vibración, básicamente.
It's the same as the hand. You wouldn't play the drums like this. Okay, because the problem is when you do that on the bass drum, now not only am I not making one note with one movement, now I'm making one note with two movements.
Dice que, bueno, habéis visto cómo hace lo de los timbales, que es lo mismo, y que ahora lo que intenta conseguir es dar no solo una nota con cada movimiento, sino más de una.
So, bass drum in, now, out. One note, out, right? Rather than one note, comes out. Now I'm ready to play another note again.
Dice que al sacar la maza, pues que está preparado para otro golpe.
So, I tap with the ankle. So, full leg. Release, beater, and then tap with the ankle, just like here.
Vale, entonces, deja tocas la maza y con el tobillo da la siguiente.
Down, tap, down, tap, and then tap with my leg up. So, see, down, tap, tap with my arm up, down, up. So I can play. Okay, so you hear the accent, the dynamic, just like we have with our hands. Let's say I want to play two notes. Take the tap out.
Ahorita del tap, escuchéis el acento de forma natural.
So down, up, down, up. It's the same, I can play much faster with less energy, okay? If you want to play two notes with the foot, two notes with the foot, two notes with the hand, you reverse the motion. So you put the accent on the second note. So, okay? So, same with the hand. Accent on the second note. So it makes it much easier to play, and I'll show you how to practice it, okay? You practice it on the hi-hat.
Os voy a enseñar cómo practicarlo. Este es el truco. El hi-hat.
If you want to learn how to play the bass drum really, really well, you practice on the hi-hat. To get used to pulling the beater out of the bass drum, it's the same as splashing the hi-hat. You know, splashing.
Para acostumbrarse a quitar la maza del bombo, que dice que los suyos hacen un splash en el hi-hat.
So you kick with the heel like this, right? Splash. Okay. Same here. Releases the beater. This way, it's like this. Closing the hi-hat, so splash, and then tap, but makes a splash, and then splash, the leg up, splash, 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 splash. If it closes in there, then you're doing it wrong.
Ajá, dice que tienes que todo el rato splash, que es lo que si se cierra, que lo estás haciendo mal.
So like this. So, like that, you want it to splash, 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 so splash, splash.
It's a rebrush. It's a actually you're splashing the hi-hats with both movements.
Right. All, every movement splashes it. The down, the tap, and the and the tap with the up. Yeah. Okay, it'll drive your parents crazy, but but that's how you work on it, okay? And then you move it to the pedal. Or two. See? So same with the hand, same with the foot. And I put them between each other. So down, down, tap, tap, up, up. Hand-to-hand, same technique. Okay? It's a mini set?
Okay. So, one of the things that I want to talk about is becoming a better musician who plays drums. Because there's a big difference between a great musician who plays drums and a great drummer.
Una de las cosas que quiero enseñaros es eso, el conocer las diferencias para tocar bien la batería.
One of the things that's difficult about the drums is that the instrument doesn't have a sustain to it, like other instruments do.
Una de las cosas que tiene la batería es que no tiene un sustain para, para como otros instrumentos.
Okay. So on the drums, you know, this is a 16th note.
Sí, esto es una semicorchea.
This is an eighth note.
Un octavo.
This is a quarter note.
Mira.
You know, half note.
Nine.
Whole note. It's all the same, okay?
Son todas iguales.
One of the fun things about the drums is that the first day that you start playing,
una de las cosas divertidas de la batería es que cuando empiezas a tocarla,
you can make a note.
Puedes hacer una nota.
Okay.
Batería.
I have a little daughter. She's 7 years old. She can make notes all over the drums.
Su hija de 7 años, a diferencia de otros instrumentos, puede hacer notas.
Right, but she cannot control what happens between the notes.
Pero no puede controlar lo que pasa entre las notas.
Okay, so the challenge here is not the note.
Entonces el reto aquí no es la nota.
But what happens between the notes.
Lo que ocurre entre las notas.
Okay, the great drummers, the great musicians who play drums, are the ones who have the best control over what happens between the notes.
Los mejores baterías, lo que les diferencia es el control que tienen entre las notas.
The problem with most drummers nowadays is their concentration is only on playing more notes.
El problema que él ve actualmente es que la gente, los músicos, los baterías se concentran casi más en cuántas notas soy capaz de tocar.
So, if you don't learn anything here tonight, but one thing, I want you to remember this.
Si no vais a aprender nada, me gustaría que al menos guardaréis esto.
If you're only thinking about the note that you're playing and not what's happening between it, you have completely the wrong idea about what we're attempting to do here with the drums.
Okay. que lo que ha hecho hasta ahora. O sea, si no tenéis el control de lo que ocurre entre las notas, no lo estáis haciendo bien. O no lo habéis cogido la forma adecuada.
So, if you think about it, let's say I play guitar, or I play a horn, I become responsible for the sustain of the notes.
Digamos que yo toco la guitarra, si yo tocara la guitarra o algo de metal, tendría que preocuparme más en esto.
Okay, so a 16th note on a saxophone is, you know.
Semicorchea en un saxofón es un beat.
Yeah, and eighth note, ba.
Eso en una corchera es un
ba. You know, quarter note, ba.
La negra
es. Half note, ba, right?
La blanca.
They have to hold the note. They have to make the sustain of the note.
Ellos tienen que controlar la nota.
Even though our instrument doesn't do that, we have to think like that.
Aunque nuestro instrumento no lo haga, nosotros tenemos que pensar así.
So one way to practice that is with the brushes.
Una forma de practicar esto es con las escobillas.
How many people own brushes?
¿Cuántos tenéis escobillas?
A few. How many people can play brushes? One. Yeah.
Many no podéis tocar.
Yeah. Many drummers are brush owners.
Muchas baterías tienen, son propietarios de.
Yeah. Big difference between a brush owner and a brush player.
Muy, una gran diferencia entre un propietario de escobillas y un músico, un batería de escobillas.
But what happens with the brushes is we have to play the sustain, right? So a 16th note is this.
Una semicorchea, se me lo voy a aprender.
2, 3, and. Okay. Notice, it's not. It's not real. It's. There's a length to it.
Notarlo, hay que hacerlo.
Eighth note.
2, 3, 4.
Okay. Length. Quarter note.
3, 4. Half note.
Oh, that's it.
Whole note. 3, 4.
Okay. So all of a sudden, instead of it being ding da da ding da da ding da da ding,
and what are the notes?
Say ding da da ding ding da da ding. So instead of it playing ding da da ding da da ding da da ding, think like a drummer. Tap tap da da tap da da tap da da.
And what are the como batería?
It's
da da da.
A different understanding of the way notes are played and the way they're expressed in their phrase.
Es una forma diferente de ver las notas y las frases en la letra.
Okay, so practice playing just simple notes but with brushes, making the actual sustain, the actual level of sustain with the brush.
Entonces practicar con las escobillas haciendo el sustain.
So, like this.
Así.
About all of that. Then when I go to play with the sticks, I think the same way.
Yo hago todo esto, entonces cuando voy a las baquetas, pues pienso igual.
So, instead of me playing a rock beat and thinking this,
tick, 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 t
where the space in there can get smaller or longer in my brain, or in with my hands, right? Your hands can say, I'm uncomfortable with the space, and come in too early.
Su cerebro, que las manos piensen eso, que pueden, que ya pasa tanto tiempo que es muy bien. Bueno, que el tipo lo que quiere hacer es que no haya, o sea, pensar esos espacios de una forma cerebral diferente.
So this is what happens. Tick, 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 right? And then easily it can do this. Right? It speeds up a little, slows down a little. If you're thinking, da, 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 then the space fills up.
Entonces los espacios se rellenan.
And you don't come in early or late.
Y entonces no llegas ni tarde ni...
It helps you keep time better.
Te ayuda a mantener mejor los tiempos,
right? Da, 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 da. Like
that. I think like this. You know. Wait.
It's too easy to make a mistake. It's too easy to come down early.
Es muy fácil confundirse, es muy fácil golpear antes.
Have you ever heard a drummer that sounds like this?
¿Habéis escuchado alguna batería sonar así?
Okay. What's happening there is he's constantly coming in too early and then knowing, oh, I'm coming in too early, I'm speeding up, so adjust and correct, and then it happens again, and it's happening over and over again, so you get this weird weaving effect.
Lo que ocurre es que das ese efecto de que vas y vienes porque te adelantas, después intentas corregirlo, te vuelves a adelantar, te das cuenta que te has adelantado.
So one of the ways to fix that is by always practicing with a metronome or a click metronome. But making sure that it's subdivided, making sure that it's broken down into the different kinds of notes that we have to play. The problem is, too many people practice with a metronome. Okay. Most teachers say, most teachers say, practice with a
metronome.
But listen the way that can sound. I can sound two different ways, like this.
¿Cómo puedo sonar? ¿Puedo sonar?
But if I put on the metronome, the actual this beat is based on eighth notes.
¿Esto está basado en ocho notas?
If I put on the metronome eighth notes,
yes.
And I always practice with a subdivided metronome. Subdividing means you're playing all the different subdivisions of a beat. So you can take one beat and make it into 5, 4, 3, 2, or just 1. See, those are all subdivisions. Yeah. That I said more than you said. You got it. Okay. Alright. So now I'm playing the eighth notes. But the other thing it's doing is doing this. Da 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 da. It's giving me the eighth note, the full length. It's telling me where each eighth note comes, so it's giving me the length of those notes, right?
Me da la gente y me dice dónde está el principio.
Da 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 da. One, two, three. Now, the weave is gone. Okay? So you need to practice all of your eighth note beats and fills with this metronome. So on.
Even fill.
You can see every single instrument that I play on the drum set, right with the click, right with the click, okay? This is step one. Even if it's a foot on the hi-hat, it's right with the click, everything. Okay. Are you saying what I'm saying?
Almost saying, okay.
Okay, but listen, you have to do this for all of the subdivisions. That's easy. That's only two notes in a beat, eighth notes. One and two and three and four. And you need to do it for 16th notes. One and a two and a three and a four. You have four notes in a beat.
Sí. Tienes que hacer todas las subdivisiones, bien sea en seis en corcheas, como HL, o en seis corcheas como la.
Just because it's slow,
es una locura, como se escucha.
Thank you.
Vamos ya.
Thank you. The same thing has to happen for triplets.
Una cosa para tresillos.
It drives everyone else loco too, and they have to hear it. But it's great practice, you know, because when you go to play without it, you know what it sounds like in your head, right? So now if I want to play that groove, if you don't know what that sounds like, if you've never practiced it like that, how do you possibly know how to make it happen on the drums? You have to hear it. You have to hear what it sounds like for those notes to be going by with the correct spacing.
Dice que si nunca lo has escuchado, no has trabajado nunca, que no sabes cómo realmente va a sonar. Y tienes que trabajar esas notas para que haya el espaciado correcto entre una y otra.
So even if it's simple, you hear those eighth notes, da 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 da. It gives you that. You hear the right spacing at those tempos, and it helps you make everything solid, and it stops you from that weird weaving, speeding up and slowing down thing. Okay?
Dice que aunque sean corcheas, tengáis en cuenta de trabajarlo así, porque eso ayuda a quitar toda esa onda de aceleración y deceleración en el.
Okay. Okay, so if you want to, well, first off, is there questions about that? Anything that I said? Yeah.
When you play with
castellano, hombre, luego ya.
Say in Spanish and English if you can. Yeah.
Cuando practicaste lo de las subdivisiones con las escobillas, hiciste un sweep en cada una de ellas, digamos. When the practice is with the subdivision 16 days and the quarter note with the sweeps, you sweep it with the length of the each note.
Yeah.
So, can you repeat it?
Yeah.
16 days, triplet.
You know, I talked about earlier that, you know, on the drums, every note sounds the same. Eighth note, 16th note, quarter note. So I think of it more like with brushes where I have to play da, da, da. I'm thinking about the full sustain of the note. So what that does is I hear the backbeat as a half note. So rather than hearing it half, I hear this backbeat as a half note. Because I hear that half note with that length, I can adjust it and create a different feel. Okay?
Él dice que un backbeat, un mano más normal, así de 4x4, la nota, la caja, la nota, la siente como si fuera una blanca, y que así puede mejorar un poco, un groove diferente.
So, for instance, you don't want to sound like a machine, but that is the first step, is being able to play it correctly. Because remember what I said, we got to get rid of the weave first. So we don't want this. You know, we want it to be correct and solid. But one of the things that's so important is that you have your own individual sound and voice. And what's really cool about that is that everybody in this room sounds completely different on the drums. If you understand the space between the notes and you can control it, then you can add your personality to it. So if I hear the sustain of a note short, da, 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 it's going to feel more aggressive. If I feel it a little longer, da, 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 it's still in the same space, but I can feel it all the way to the next downbeat, or a little bit shorter, I can feel it in a different way. It will change the way I sound on the drums. So like this. Da, 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 da. Sudden the beat feels heavier, it feels more heavy when I do that.
El sentimiento es como más pesado, más pesado cuando lo hace más
largo. Right? So if I want to feel the beat like this, 1, 2, 3. Maybe that, like John Bonham. Lengthen that. He's not thinking. You know, he's hearing, you can feel how he's hearing that. You know, you want to play like Phil Collins, you know. You know, something like that. It's aggressive. It's small, it's shorter sounding, so it feels aggressive. If he felt it the other way, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, you can feel the weight behind it if I change the sustain. So in that way, remember what I said at the very beginning? We're talking to each other.
Bueno, recordad, básicamente, bueno, habéis visto lo que ha explicado de Phil Collins, de John Bonham, y que, bueno, que recordáis lo que ha dicho del principio. Sintáis las cosas un poco más largas.
So I can put inside of you, as a listener, I can put energy into you.
Quiero poner cierta energía en vosotros, sí, como escuchantes.
Or I can put relaxation, I can make you relax.
Te puede relajar.
I can also put tension in you.
Puedo poner tensión en
nosotros. By not playing that cymbal where you thought I was going to play that cymbal.
No, 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 el plato no creí que iba a dar, ¿eh?
So that's the fun part, is that I get to take you on this journey through what I'm doing, you know? Things that are exciting, things that are relaxing, things that build tension, things that release tension. Yeah? I'll give you an example, okay? I'll play a song real quick.
Here we go.
When you're doing that eighth note thing, you're laid, it's a kind of laid back.
It's laid back because the sustain is felt longer. So now the position of the next note is a little bit back, right? That's how I teach that. Yeah. Instead of just saying, well, I can play ahead or behind, you know, it's like you play ahead by shortening the sustain a little bit, play ahead, behind by lengthening it a little bit. Yeah. Okay, so what I want you to listen for in here is the moments when I communicate with you, where things are exciting and things are less exciting and tension filled and not tension filled, and the dynamics, the up and down, just the talking of it all. So listen for that. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, gracias. So we're running a little short on time, but I want to get through a couple more things. Is there a question or two I can answer real quick before I go on?
Hay un par de cosas más que quiero hacer. ¿Entonces tenéis alguna pregunta más? Yes, no?
Yeah, go ahead.
Quiero saber.
Oh, one more. Two questions. One, two. Go ahead.
Quiero saber por qué eligió la guerra tradicional y la ventaja y la ventaja de este.
He wants to know how why did you choose the traditional grip?
Okay. Yeah. So the question is about traditional or matched grip. Matched grip is like this. The pivot point, pivot like a teeter totter, right? Like a teeter totter in the park. The pivot point is here. Not here.
El punto de balance de equilibrio está
here. All right, pressure is here. This is support.
Este soporta.
Support here. Pressure here.
Y la presión.
Like this. And I can bounce like a basketball, kind of, almost bouncing a basketball.
Puedo balancear como un jugador.
Okay.
Regular
grip. Traditional grip.
Traditional.
Like this. The reason that I play traditional grip is I marched with a marching drum corps band, and you had to play traditional.
El motivo por el que hago tradicional es porque estoy en una banda de marching.
And then many of my teachers over the years played traditional, so I just stayed playing.
Y muchos de mis profesores han tocado así, entonces yo.
A traditional grip, the pivot point is here, like that. And the support with this finger, like that, and then this is the basketball bouncing. Okay, so there's no difference. The only difference with traditional grip is this. With match grip, the weight of my hand is on top of the stick.
El peso de mi mano, la diferencia es que el peso de mi mano aquí está arriba.
With traditional grip,
con el tradicional,
no weight on top of my hand.
No hay peso arriba.
So I can never play as light with this as I can with this.
Nunca podré tocar de una forma tan suave como en el tradicional como en la otra.
Right.
Y la viceversa, no voy a afectar la pérdida de pegada.
On the other hand, if you prefer to play with the
traditional,
you are taking the traditional on your left hand,
Left hand.
Then why you are not playing on the other hand too?
Oh, like this?
Yeah.
That's no. No, because it's because you. The drum set was designed around this side of the drum set with this approach. You know, this I can't play back onto this side of the drum set.
No puedo tocar así para poder acercarme a la batería.
Sí, eso está
siendo
claro. ¿En qué afecta la pegada? A la pegada, a la potencia que puedes lanzar de un modo u otro.
Do you think you lose power with the traditional grip?
Yeah, because see, here's the thing. The power doesn't come from, this is the problem. Most people, the power comes from how high they lift their stick. When you use the molar technique that I talked about, the power comes from the elbow, the whip of it, like a whip.
Sí, entonces en el sistema molar la pegada viene del lado.
You know, like a bull whip. And you know, a whip, you know, if I hit you with a whip right there, doesn't hurt so much, you know, but if I hit him out there with the end of the whip, it hurts a lot. Yeah. So it's the same thing with this whipping motion. I get the same whip with the arm, so I can play very loud without bringing my sticks up high, because you don't want to do that. you say you don't want to get the power from raising your stick again.
El poder no viene de la relatividad, ¿no?
Because this takes time to get back down from here to here. So with the molar technique, I'm staying. Hard from here, from up there, but I don't have this all this time, right? You watch, you know, Stuart Copeland with the Police, whip very loud, you know. Vinny Caliuta, strong player, a lot of loud players, Steve Jordan, and many great traditional players. But, you know, the main thing is. The main thing is when I want to play swing or something light with the left hand, it really helps to have that.
Ayuda mucho para hacer las cosas que.
Like. I can control the stick height by picking up my hand, playing very light. So it's hard to play like that. I can't do it.
He said that he feels that on the left hand you have the stick quite
very loose.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very loose. Yeah. Yeah, both hands very loose. Yeah. Not tight grip. One key, very important.
Una clave muy importante.
You mucho importante. Do not close this gap.
No cierres este
espacio. No. You know, if you watch this gap and it's closing, see my arm tensing up.
Tensas el brazo.
So always keep that gap open.
Tienes que mantenerlo abierto.
Loose the gap. Okay? Real quick, one more, go ahead.
It's about the 18. You are using an 18. And he's asking if you tune it in any way, or why are you using it?
Yeah, I use the extra bass drum because I play a lot of different styles, and a lot of them sometimes it's jazz or hip hop, and I have an open bass drum sound. So this is a closed bass drum sound and an open bass drum sound.
But ahora le pregunto, que lo que hace, como tocan estilos muy variados, tiene un 22 y tiene un 18 para cosas abiertas. But time to time you use both.
Yeah. Yeah, because like swing. Much better sound for swing jazz.
Es un sonido mucho mejor para el swing, ¿no?
And also, if I play it very light, with a big mic, put a mic on it very light, it's for hip hop. You know. Or, fast. I like it with that, like.
style, works for that style really well. So use it for that.
Sí, que lo uso para eso.
Okay, but I tune it just like a tom, right? Like a tom.
Lo afina como si fuera un tom. Like if it were a tom.
Like a what?
Like if you...
Like another 40 tom. Yeah. But in
sí, service. Si fuera un otro 18 en base, pero en
poco. Okay, I want to talk about something very quick because we're running out of time.
Le quiero hablar sobre una cosa muy rápida.
I just want to tell you about the Sonic Clear Bearing Edge from Mapex.
Os quiero hablar sobre el nuevo sistema de
If you don't know what the bearing edge is the part of the drum that actually touches the drum head.
Sí, si sabéis lo que son los bordes son la parte que toca el patch.
Okay. And the bearing edge itself actually makes some of the most important part of the way a drum sounds. So probably the most important is what the drum's made out of, and the second most important part is the bearing edge, how the wood touches the head.
May you repeat the two?
I said probably the two most important parts of what makes up a drum is the actual composition of the shell, like what kind of wood, what it's made out of.
Sí, entonces, okay. Las dos cosas que pueden afectar en el sonido son la madera que estamos utilizando y los ángulos de la bueno y el borde, cómo está hecho el borde del tom.
So what Mapex has done,
lo que Mapex ha hecho,
in years past, and in some other drum manufacturers,
y en otras fábricas.
So you're looking at the edge of the wood there.
Can we guys
wood. The drum. That's the edge of the drum. The drum head goes right on top of that. Uh-huh. Right, you're seeing over there in the circle, right?
Sí, la madera, exacto. Eso es como la terminación actual de la madera, lo que veis en el dibujo.
Some manufacturers, the top of the drum looks like this.
Algunas fábricas, la terminación de la madera es como se está enseñando.
Or the top of the drum has an angle and then it's straight down.
O tiene un ángulo y entonces directamente baja.
If you've ever taken a drum head before and put it on the drum and it rocks back and forth, it doesn't sit flat.
Si coges el parche y en el y al ponerlo en el tom se mueve.
Yes. What you want to have happen is the head should sit on the drum completely flat and you should be able to spin it around without it rocking, you know.
No, then you assist the movie.
Do what?
Major.
Yeah. When you put the drum head on the drum, when you first put it on the drum,
yeah.
You should be able to spin it around. It should not rock around. It should sit flat.
Debería de ser capaz de darle vuelta sin que baile.
So what Mapex has done is made a special cut, a special round cut on the outside of the drum shell.
Lo que Mapex ha hecho es un corte especial redondeado por fuera.
And what that does is the edge of the drum head is like this, the same, and now the Mapex drum is the same, so it sits perfectly on the drum head. The drum head sits perfectly on the drum shell.
La forma redondeada que lo han hecho es igual que la terminación del parche, entonces eso permite que se asiente el uno con el otro.
So it makes a very big difference in the sound.
Lo que provoca una gran diferencia en el sonido.
So this is an older drum.
El de azul es un tom antiguo.
That does not have the sonic clear edge.
Que no tiene la terminación.
It's got a standard edge, which is cut at an angle and then straight down. So you can hear.
Okay.
And this is the new Saturn V drum set, which has a sonic
grid.
So. Thank you.
Sure.
Much
more sustained.
Much bigger sound and much more sustained. Sustained is the length of the sound.
Más sólido y más sostenido.
So this makes a much bigger sound out of the drums and much more sustained, and also makes it much easier to tune the drum.
Lo que hace que tengamos el nuevo sistema más sonido, más, o sea, más volumen, más sustain y...
Más fácil de
hacer. Más fácil al final, es verdad.
And Mapex is now putting that on all of their drum lines. So even Mars and Armory, which are very inexpensive drum sets, all have the Sonic Clear Edge. And so it's really great of Mapex to spend the time. Obviously, they're going to do it on a pro drum set like Saturn V. But for Mapex to spend the time on an inexpensive drum set that only costs 450 euros, most companies don't do that. So.
Entonces Mapex aplica todo esto en todas las series que tienen y es algo que muchas otras empresas no hacen.
So you can hear.
The other thing is when the head is very flat, it tunes very even.
Entonces la otra cosa es que cuando el parche queda muy plano.
Yeah. So if you've ever tuned your drums, oh yeah, go ahead.
He
said when the head is very flat, it tunes very even all around. Even. Equal. Equal all around. Yeah.
Sí, que cuando el parche está plano, pues es mucho más fácil dar una afinación igual.
So you can see. I have no muffling on the drums, no moon gel, no muffling at all. Yeah, so, you know, but it doesn't go, you know, those kind of sounds where you like,
tape and moon gel and
trying to deaden and sound engineers like it's ringing and you know, so you don't have to do that. You don't have to mute the drums and put tape on.
Yeah, so
you know, it's a controlled, nice sound, no weird rings and sounds in it. So
no hay nada, el sonido está controlado.
Easy to tune it. Okay? So that's the Sonic Clear Bearing Edge. Is there any questions about that?
¿Alguna pregunta sobre esto?
Okay. So we're running short on time, but I just want to do a couple things really quick. You know, a lot of things that I talked about, you know, you need to use in different styles of music and playing contemporary styles. So what I did is I brought a medley of songs that I've played on that you might know, and I thought I would play through that and demonstrate some of the things that I talked about as far as the feeling of grooves and things like that.
Entonces, la verdad que me ha pasado un poco. Él toca cosas muy variadas, os ha enseñado un poco y más o menos.
Lo que va a enseñar,
sí, por eso.
Lo que has hablado.
Sí, que os va a enseñar un poco de lo que os ha hablado.
Okay, everybody okay?
Yeah.
Okay, for a couple more minutes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sí, son un par de minutos más.
But it's not possible. I won't ever change.
glasses on. Okay, we've been here a while. I want to thank everybody for coming out. Thank you so much.
Muchas gracias a todos por venir.
Thank you to Agustin and the store. I don't know where
that is. Gracias a Agustin y Leturiana.
Yeah, there you are, right there. And of course to Ruben. And how about a hand for Mapex Drums for putting this on with the store? Please. You know, also, I have all Zildjian symbols. You guys are welcome to come up and look at this. Remo drum heads. And I have signature model sticks and brushes with Big Firth.
Tiene también tanto los las baquetas como las escobillas de prima propiedad.
Yeah, and this is actually my snare drum that I helped design, called the Versatus snare drum with Mapex. It's a Black Panther series, the high-end snare drum.
Y tenéis también la caja que está hecha por el Versatus. La tenéis aquí, la tenéis si queréis probarla también allí en una sala de otro lado. Que es una caja hecha por él.
You said a lot of stuff I didn't say at that time.
I say what I mean.
I'm joking. Sure. Okay. Anyway, thanks to Ruben. Thanks for the interpreting. Thank you, Ruben. Thank you. And oh, there you go. Oh, yeah. Thank you for helping. Thank you. Okay. All right. One last question from anybody.
¿Alguna última pregunta de alguien?
Okay. Going. Go ahead.
Quiero saber cómo. ¿Cómo afrontas un poco el trabajo de estudio? O sea, si te preparas de alguna forma, si, o cómo has preparado tu larga carrera, que bueno, los que ya tenemos sabemos de ti hace tiempo, pues sí que tenemos el DVD, tu libro, etcétera, que está muy bien, pero sí que me gustaría saber cómo has desarrollado todo eso para ser tan preciso y tan bueno.
Okay.
He wanna know how do you face and how do you develop the way you study and how do you face?
Okay. Well, first.
In the studio.
Yeah. Okay. Well, first, let me say something. You know, I started playing when I was 8 years old, and I started taking lessons with a teacher, and I've never stopped taking lessons. I take lessons to this day. I've never stopped taking lessons my whole life.
When you was 8? Eight.
I started when I was 8.
Sí, yo empecé cuando tenía 8 y no paré de tocar y de dar clases con otra gente desde entonces, ¿no? Tomar lecciones.
Yeah. And today's my 21st birthday, so it's been 3 years, 18 years or 13 years. 13 years.
Yo ya hace, en realidad, 46, sí.
But, you know, I still take lessons. I study with Peter Erskine, one of the great jazz drummers.
I studied with
Peter Erskine. Yeah, one of the great jazz drummers.
Dave Weka.
Yeah, I also study with Dave Weka, then Steve Gadd, Ed Thickman, Jeff Hamilton, Jim Chapin, Adam Nussbaum. Different, but my whole life I've studied. I still take lessons. I think it's really important that you have a coach.
Y todavía sigo teniendo clases. Y además creo que es muy importante tener alguien que te pueda ir guiando.
You know, even Real Madrid players who are the best players in the world, they have a coach.
Incluso los mejores jugadores del mundo de Real Madrid tienen un entrenador, alguien que los guíe.
Right. So, I'm as serious about what I do as they are. They make more money at it.
Eres tan serio como pueden ser los jugadores de Real Madrid, aunque ellos hagan más dinero.
Pregúntale cuál de todos ha sido el que más le ha
influenciado. Which of your teachers was the one who give you more, who influenced more on you?
I think they all did different ways, but probably Steve Gadd. Changed my thinking. Not out here, more in here.
Why? No, no, forma en la técnica, sino en la mentalidad.
Yeah. Okay. So I actually got an email from a couple of people. I don't know where you're at, but to bring some CDs. I have a couple CDs of some of the stuff that you heard, if you guys want any of them. We have only maybe 10 left, because we played the Tam Tam Festival last night, and I sold a bunch of them last night. So we have some. I have a few here if somebody wants those.
Si alguien quiere alguno de ustedes, tiene varios. Ayer estuvo en el festival de Tam Tam y traía muchos más, pero ya no.
But real quick before we go, maybe there's a record that I did a few years ago called Arrival, and it actually featured 9 other drummers playing together with a band, with a choir and a band and big band horns and everything. And we had 2 drum set parts that were written for the songs.
So for each song or you?
Yeah, each song there's 2 drum set parts written for it. It's called Arrival. We play with the band, you know, there's a choir and everything.
En uno de los CDs está tocado con 2 baterías y una banda.
And one of the songs was written about with Indian musicians from southern India.
Y una de las canciones está grabada con músicos indios.
And if it's okay, I want to play that one song. It has Steve Smith and me and Pete Lockett, the great percussionist from London, all 3 of us on the song.
Y va a tocar, si nos importa, la canción donde está él.
Yeah, it's an Indian influence, Steve Smith, Pete Lockett, and I. And we do some vocal Indian percussion.
So. Vocal
okay, is okay? One more, real quick?
Okay.
Gracias.
So leave this mic on, because I gotta do the vocals. This one. Yeah, I'll turn it over here to you. Yeah. Okay. So the other drummer that you hear is Steve Smith.
El otro batería es Steve Smith.
He's pretty good, that guy. We'll be right back.
Gracias. Thank you. Thank you for coming.